Today we're looking at a fantastic budget watch from a brand that you may or may not be familiar with. You get this watch for around $60 and it has three really cool features for that price. It has a full titanium case, one of the brightest fully lumed dials that I've ever tested, and 100 meters of water resistance. Today we're taking a look at the titanium field watch from Alba, which is actually Seiko. Hey guys, welcome back to Just the Watch. My name's Dave, I live in Japan, and I love to collect affordable watches. And Japan is a great place to be if you're interested in affordable watches because they make some of the best affordable watches in the world. Seiko is kind of a fan favorite, one of the most renowned and historic watchmakers in the world, and probably Japan's premier watch manufacturer. But their watches tend to start around the $100 range, and more recently they've sort of been jumping up in price. Most people tend to consider the Seiko 5 sports models to be their new entry-level watches, around $200 to $300, but they actually have a number of sub-brands that make much more affordable watches. And here in Asia, Alba is one of those sub-brands that's really popular. I don't think it's as well known or as easily found in other parts of the world as it is over here. I believe in Europe, their sub-brand Loris is a little bit more popular, and actually Loris makes a watch very similar to this. When I initially started posting some pictures of this watch, I got a lot of comments from people saying, oh, that watch is identical to one that Loris makes, but it's actually not. There's some really key differences here, and I'll get into that in a little bit too. But first, let's talk about the actual specifications of this watch that you're getting. So most importantly, this is a full titanium case. You get a 38 millimeter case, 18 millimeter lugs, 45 millimeters lug to lug. It has a slightly domed mineral crystal, and with that mineral crystal taken into account, it comes in at right around 11 millimeters thick. You are getting 100 meters of water resistance with a screw down case back, but only a push pull crown. Inside, you're getting the Seiko VJ53 quartz day date movement, which being a Seiko quartz movement, I'm sure is hyper accurate and is doing a surprisingly good job of hitting the second markers on the watch. Finishing on the case is very simple, but it actually looks a lot better in person than it did in the product shots. You get some very fine brushing on the case itself, and then the bezel appears to have kind of a matte or bead blasted sort of finish to it. But this being a titanium watch, it has that kind of dull gray color, and you don't really pick out the finishing details very much. Still, the case shape is very elegant. I like the lug design. That's this nice curved lug design that comes out. Crown guards kind of adds a little bit of interest to it as well. And the really compact dimensions on this watch help it to wear insanely well. This being a quartz watch and this being a titanium watch means that it is feather light. The watch head itself weighs only 28 grams. If you take my Seiko 5 SNXS77, which is a 37 millimeter automatic watch from Seiko with a stainless steel case, that weighs 47 grams compared to this one's 28 grams. And for maybe a more fair comparison, if you take my plastic Casio W217H, which does have a quartz movement, that one weighs 21 grams to this one's 28 grams. And yet again, this one has a metal case and a glass crystal, which means that depending on the strap that you pair this with, you may find yourself often forgetting that you even have a watch on your wrist because it's so light and comfortable. Now, this is a very small watch. It's smaller than I typically wear, but I think it works okay on my 7.5-inch wrist. It has a fairly large dial, so visually it doesn't really strike me as being a small watch. I think it looks like a classically proportioned field watch on my wrist. It's actually turned out to be more of a benefit because that small size makes it, again, very comfortable on the wrist, especially combined with how light it is. The strap that this one comes with is a very simple, very soft nylon single pass strap. It's comfortable and it fits the aesthetics of the watch, but I've found that this watch is really an absolute strap monster, and I've had a lot of fun pairing it up with different straps. I wish it would have had 20 millimeter lugs instead of 18 millimeter lugs because I had to work a little bit harder to find some good 18 millimeter straps to go with this, but I did track some down and I'll show you those later in the video. I really like the dial design and handset on this. It's a classic field watch layout with your 12 hour Arabics and then a 24 hour military time on the inner ring. You get blacked out syringe shaped hour and minute hands that really have a nice elegant look to them. And again, that fully lumed dial, which just looks amazing in the dark if you're into that sort of thing. And if you are into Lume, make sure you head over to the t-shirt shop and pick up one of these Lume Shot t-shirts. I've got these along with a lot of other cool ones in my shop. So this being a watch from one of Seiko's sub-brands, I suspect that the Lume on this is Lumibrite. It's definitely as bright as other Lumibrite watches that I have tested. And when you do a fully lumed dial, this is the way you want to do the layout. I've seen a lot of brands, they try and get all fancy with, you know, putting applied markers on there that have a different color Lume. I feel like that actually hurts the actual usability of the watch after dark. It's much easier to read a watch if you just have a loomed background and then black markers and black hands. That gives you the most contrast and the greatest readability.
Looking at this time lapse, we can see the strengths of the lume on the Alba. So this is a fully lumed dial with what I believe is Seiko LumiBright, and it is hanging in there and competing really well against the Zelos Horizons, which is using a combination of BGW9 and C3. At the end of 1 hour, the Zelos just barely edges it out, but because the Alba went with blacked out indexes and hands, where the Zelos went with fully lumed indexes and hands, I feel like the Alba is actually still a little bit more legible, which is pretty crazy for a $60 field watch. A score of 8 on the J score means that it's about 80% as bright as my Seiko Samurai. That also means that it's the brightest field watch of any that I've tested, and it significantly outpaces most of the divers that I've tested as well. So you're going to be really hard-pressed to find a watch with better lume for the price.
You're going to notice the lume on this watch every time you walk indoors from outside. It's a really fun, really cool effect that's really a big part of this watch. Now, going back to the comparisons of this watch to the watches from Loris. Loris has two field watches that are both very similar to this. One of them is a LumiBright model in a stainless steel case. And that one looks very similar to this watch. I feel like the case design is slightly different. I think this one has a little bit more elegant, a little bit more slender lugs that I like slightly better, but overall very similar case design. However, that Loris one is stainless steel, whereas this one is titanium. Now, Loris does also make a titanium field watch, but that one has kind of a more different case design with a bezel with some different accents, and the dial is completely different. It does not have a fully lumed dial. So if you're going with Loris, you kind of have to choose whether you want the titanium or whether you want the fully lumed dial. With Alba, they've combined both of those into one watch, and I really like this package. For $60, you get the titanium, you get the 100 meters of water resistance, and you get the fully lumed dial. And I think I'm more drawn to sort of the dial on this one. I feel like it's a little bit cleaner, a little bit more well done than the Loris versions. The challenge, again, might be tracking this one down because Seiko seems to be using the Alba line more in Asia, whereas Loris, again, maybe more popular in Europe. Finally, one of my favorite things about this watch is its versatility when it comes to straps. You can get a lot of wear out of this watch depending on the strap that you pair it up with. And while the stock strap is nice and comfortable, it doesn't seem like a particularly high quality strap, and I don't think it's going to last very long. So I went out and tried to pick up some other 18mm straps to pair it up with. Straps Co. has a pretty wide selection of straps in a lot of different sizes, including 18mm, so I contacted them and asked them to send me a couple of watch straps in. They gave me some for free, so thanks to them for that. This being a relatively thin watch that's very light, it works great on NATO straps. I really like it on this kind of orange and black seatbelt NATO. And putting it on a NATO strap like this makes it a perfect companion for any sort of hiking or camping or outdoor activities. But you could also use this watch in the water as a swimming watch, because with that 100 meters of water resistance, it'll be perfectly fine for surfing, swimming, light snorkeling, scuba diving. Maybe not deep scuba diving, but you know. So you can throw it on a rubber strap, looks really cool on that, and you've got a great swimming watch. But for my favorite pairing, I wound up purchasing an 18mm leather strap from Nomad Watchworks. And this strap is about, this is like a $35 leather strap, so it's about half the cost of the watch. But it really looks great on this watch. It helps the watch to really have more of a premium look. And putting it on a leather strap like this, it just makes a great casual or accent piece to whatever you're wearing. If you want to take it out for a night on the town, it's going to make a great companion for a date night or something like that. There are a few things that I don't like about this watch. The biggest one is the mineral crystal, but that's completely to be expected in this price range. It would be pretty shocking to see a sapphire crystal from anything that Seiko is producing in this price range. So I can't really fault them for that too much. Also, the 18mm lugs, I don't have as many straps for that, but I think that proportionally that's kind of the right choice for a watch of this size, because this is a pretty small watch. And finally, I feel like the day and date readout looks just a little bit cheap. I don't know, it's not that noticeable, but it just kind of feels like it has like a thinner, lower quality readout than I've seen on, you know, a lot of automatic watches. But overall, I really enjoy this watch. It just makes a great kind of everyday watch. It's really comfortable on the wrist with a ton of versatility, and that fully lumed dial really does add a lot of fun and enjoyment to it. So if you're in Asia and you can track this down, I think it's a great one to pick up. If you are in North America or Europe, you might have to look for one of those companies that ships products from Japan. I think you can get it for not too much, but it's a really cool little watch. Let me know what you guys think down below in the comments. And let me know if you like seeing watches that are more kind of JDM or Asian market watches that, you know, if you live in North America or Europe, you might have a harder time tracking down. Or if it just kind of frustrates you seeing cool watches that you can't get your hands on. Also, don't forget to check out the t-shirt store. But that's going to wrap it up for today. Thank you guys again for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye. We'll be right back.